Eurasian water milfoil is an aquatic weed that is native to Europe, Asia, and Northern Africa. It was introduced into North America on several occasions since the 1880s in the aquatic plant trade and via ship's ballast. It is now widely naturalized throughout much of North America. This species grows in freshwater lakes, springs, marshes, and rivers with slow-moving water. It can grow in water depths from a few inches to 30 feet. It can tolerate a wide variety of temperatures and brackish water and capitalizes on disturbance and nutrient runoff. Eurasian water milfoil displaces native plant species, impedes water flow, and it damages fishing, hunting, boating, and other recreational sectors. Decaying plant material can decrease oxygen levels, which is detrimental to fish and other organisms. It is capable of hybridizing with the native northern milfoil, creating an even more aggressive invasive plant. Eurasian water milfoil is a submersed aquatic perennial with roots typically anchored in the hydrosoil. Though it produces seeds, seedlings are rare in the field, and it primarily reproduces vegetatively. New stems grow from stolons and roots in spring. Roots are slender and white. They may attach stolons to the hydrosoil or grow from fragmented stem nodes. Plant stems are reddish-brown to light green, typically 6 to 20 feet long, and become more branched near the water surface, forming dense, intertwined mats. Stems are slender but thickened closer to the plant base. The leaves are all submersed and occur in whorls of four all along the stem. Leaves are 1.5 to 1.5 inches long and feather-like, with 14 to 24 pairs of filament leaflets. Flowering typically occurs in summer when tiny pink flowers are produced on pink emergent spikes that are 1.5 to 8 inches long. Fruits are four-chambered spheres. Each chamber produces a single seed. Throughout the growing season, and especially after flowering, the plant autofragments. Stem fragments containing a single node can sprout new plants. These grow roots, sometimes prior to separating from the parent plant. In warm climates, the plant continues to grow over the winter. At extremely cold sites, stems die back to the stolons, lower stem segments, and roots. New stems resprout the following spring. There are approximately 14 water milfoil species, both exotic and native, currently present in North America. Eurasian water milfoil most closely resembles the native northern milfoil, but differs in that it generally has over 14 leaflet pairs, while northern milfoil has fewer than 14. Northern milfoil also develops turions, which are specialized buds that give rise to new plants after they break free from the parent plant, while Eurasian water milfoil does not. The exotic and weedy parrot feather milfoil differs by having white flowers and two types of leaves. Its submersed leaves resemble Eurasian water milfoil, but often have more leaves per node. And its emergent leaves are slightly larger, greener, and on stems that emerge up to 1 foot out of the water. Variable leaf milfoil, which is native to the southeast USA, but invasive in the northwest, also has both submersed and emergent leaves. Its emergent leaves are lance-shaped and toothed, and they occur on stems that extend 6 to 8 inches out of the water.